Thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. As a photographer, my career is at one of the best places it's ever been. My latest book just released, I'm connecting with my audience on social media, and I have the biggest job of my career coming up. This sounds like a perfect time to downsize my entire creative operation to a small desk from IKEA. See, over the last few years, I was like most YouTubers. Cool LED lights, a couch, all the shit in my office to make it look like a set. But let's be honest, it was completely unnecessary. So today I'm going to show you how I downsized everything from my photography, YouTube channel, and podcast into such a small space, and give you all some of my thoughts on why a more minimal approach and mindset to creativity has been very beneficial to me and could also help you. What up, y'all? So behind me is the new setup that I talked about in the introduction. Y'all know I recently moved from my house outside of Atlanta, which was a pretty normal sized townhouse, to this very small apartment in the city. So far, it's been a fantastic decision. I absolutely love everything about it, but I'm not gonna lie, one of the big things that was stressing me out about this decision to move was this idea of having a studio and a creative space. I was used to having a dedicated office. Would I be okay going back to this small one bedroom type setup? And the short answer is 100% yes. I actually feel amazing. I feel dialed in, focused, I feel really creative, and it's not what I was expecting, but it kind of makes sense because I feel like I'm going back to my roots of when I started this YouTube channel way back in the day when I lived in a one bedroom apartment in 2016, and I filmed the videos the exact same way, me in front of a window with a small desk. So first and foremost, let's go over what I'm using right now for this desk setup. The first thing is this desk from IKEA right here. Super simple. I really like how like modern and white it looks. It goes great with this apartment. I think it costs less than $200. Obviously with IKEA stuff, you have to put it together yourself, which is a little bit of a pain, but it really wasn't that bad. There came with drawers underneath it, but because I'm 6'2", I wanted the extra leg room, so I didn't even bother putting those in. So it made the install and setup super simple and easy. IKEA, I think, is the way to go for desks for the most part. I mean, you can go to other places, but they kind of have everything you need, especially if you're looking for something minimal and clean. So as for the podcast, which is on my Patreon, and some of the voiceover stuff, I do use this mic sometimes for voiceovers as well, just because I can plug it straight into the computer. Kind of depends on what I'm trying to do, if I want to bake in music to the file and all that stuff. But if you want everything to be in one file, the Rode Procaster is fantastic because it goes into a memory card, so I can do music on the podcast, I can do sound effects, I can change the volume levels and everything like that. I have the microphone set up behind the plant, kind of hidden back there. It's just nice and out of the way. I know some people are gonna say this plant takes up way too much desk space, but in my opinion, it just adds something nice to the corner of this apartment. If that plant wasn't there, it would look really empty over here. So that plant is there. It also hides some of the cords, and then the microphone is the one that comes with the Rode Procaster. Forgot the exact name of it. I'll go ahead and drop it in the description if you're really interested. But that mic does well. It hides back there. Headphones I'm using these days are the Apple Air Max Pro, I believe is what they're called. I got those for the noise canceling. I use them for the podcast as well as for editing on the computer. Sometimes it can get noisy with, like stuff outside. And if I do ever have anyone over, or say someone is cooking in the kitchen and I want, you know, sound to be drowned out, those headphones are great, so I can get that little bit of extra work in such a small space, especially because the desk is in a more public area of the house. Now, the computer I'm using is the same computer I've been using, 21-inch iMac. This is an upgraded one with some extra storage, with some extra RAM, but I'm really interested in the M1 chip that is out now with the iMac. Now, for storage, to keep it simple and easy on the desk, I use a 5 TB Lacy rugged drive. Now, I do back up this drive on standard external hard drives that are more secure. That's one problem with the Lacy drives, is they have a tendency to crash. Luckily for me, you know, things have been pretty okay with them. I did have one go bad on me a while back, but for the most part, it's easy to be able to move files from here to my laptop, move around with them. You just got to be diligent about backing them up. Now, that is literally everything. This little thing under the computer right here, this stand, I did that so the computer would sit a little bit higher on the desk, more at eye level. I got that on Amazon for like 20 bucks. It also allows for some storage underneath there if you need to put anything down there. And on the right side of the desk, there's enough space left over to where I can put a camera or a book there if I'm doing something like that, or if I'm writing in a notebook, there's plenty of space for that as well. So all in all, it gets the job done. I'm not gonna lie, when I was getting all this together, I was kind of shocked as well. I was like, am I really gonna be able to make this work? But it's been fantastic. So I wanna share some of my thoughts on going from such a big setup and thinking it was gonna be a problem to this realization now that it's not. You know, this minimal approach definitely has something to it. And I've talked about this before on the channel, being minimal and like minimalism and everything on the internet, I'm kind of a hyper skeptic of. I believe in the concept of getting rid of things takes stress out of your life, but I just think for the most part on the internet, some people take it a little bit too far. But in the case of this desk and this work setup, once again, I'll give it to you guys, the minimalism community. Y'all are right. So before we talk about that, I quickly want to thank the sponsor on today's video, Squarespace. Squarespace is what I use for my website, evanramp.com, as well as 1826.com. 1826.com is on a little bit of a hiatus right now because I've been very busy with the release of my book, Stops Along the Way, which I published independently through my website, evanramp.com. Now, if Squarespace wasn't such an easy platform to use, I really don't think I would have been able to release this book and have it be as successful as it was. You see, Squarespace is built for people like me. I'm a photographer and a creative and a video maker. I'm not a web designer. I have no idea what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing with e-commerce. I'm trying to learn as I go along. So building out a web store was something that was very intimidating to me. But Squarespace makes it really easy with a variety of templates that you can go in, you can kind of check out, scroll through and decide, okay, I want my website to sort of have this look. And then you go in and customize the website accordingly with just basic functions, you know, drag and drop, moving files from your desktop into the website, changing things like colors. It's extremely simple. And if you need some help along the way, I have multiple tutorials on this channel where I break all this down. One of the best ones is where I break down how I built an online photography store. So if you're someone like me trying to sell photo books, photo prints, or any type of art via web e-commerce, that video will be great for you. I'll go ahead and link it down in the description below. So one option you have if you want to try out Squarespace is you can follow along in that video, build out your web store, and you can go to squarespace.com/evanramp to start a free trial as you follow along in the video. And then whenever you're ready to sign up and actually publish your web store on your e-commerce site, you can use code EvanRamp to get 10% off your first purchase. So that's squarespace.com/EvanRamp to start a free trial today, and then you can use code EvanRamp to get 10% off that first purchase. Thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video, and thank you to them for making projects like Stops Along the Way possible for me. So after a month and a half of switching to this more minimal approach, there's been a few observations and things that have kind of surprised me that I want to go over with y'all today. And also excuse the light changing. One interesting thing about this new apartment is the sun sets on this side. So for like 2 hours at night, this place just gets baked by the sun. That's one of the only drawbacks, but my plants absolutely love it. They are thriving right now. So the first observation that I've had is I think most creative studios you see on the internet, and I fell into this trap as well, is form over function. And what I mean is, I think it looks cool online if you're a creator to have a studio that has LED lights, that looks over the top, that looks great in the back of your videos, but in all actuality, it's completely unnecessary. And I was doing a really good job of convincing myself that I needed the coolest looking studio on the planet Earth to one, be a YouTuber, but just be a creative professional in general. It was like this weird thing I had in my head that creative professionals, pro photographers, you gotta have a cool studio set up. If you don't have that, what are you doing? Let's be real here. It doesn't define who you are as an artist. Your art defines who you are as an artist. And one really fascinating thing about having the cool looking studio is with the bigger studio, if the organization is not there, if you are not organized as you start accumulating more stuff, it actually becomes a much more stressful experience. And that's something that became so obvious to me when I switched, and is also one of the core principles of minimalism and all that, like I talked about earlier in the video. And that leads to the idea of as you accumulate more things, there's a cost associated with the accumulation of that stuff. So with camera gear, take me for example, my old office, I had camera gear everywhere. I had it all on the shelves. I had it hidden in places you couldn't see in the videos. I had it behind the couch. I had it in different bins. I had stuff in the closet. All of these different pieces of gear that I was accumulating all came with a cost, and that was storage and organization. And I was just ignoring that cost altogether, which is I think what a lot of creative people do. Is they want the cool studio, they want to get all this stuff, but they want to ignore the cost associated with all of it, which is paying for storage, taking the time to organize everything, and taking the time to put things where it needs to go when you're done using them. So what I've done with this new place is I've set up just really simple systems that work much better. I did two Pelican cases for all my gear, one for my Nikon gear, one for my Panasonic and Leica gear. I have one bin for all of my accessories, and I have one drawer for all my chargers. matters. And believe it or not, I am so much more efficient now that I have this very simple organization plan in place. I know where everything is. I know exactly what I need. If I want to run out and make photos right now, I can grab everything and get going quickly. And I couldn't do that at the old space because I was ignoring this fact of having more stuff, more maintenance. And the last interesting thing I noticed is this mental game I was always playing with myself that I needed a home office as a way to separate my life and my work. I think this is just something I'd learned from, you know, like people talking about it so much, like, oh, if you have a home office, you separate your life from your work and all this stuff. Where now I just realize, have some discipline in your head to separate your work from your life. It's really not that hard. So I don't know why I was tricking myself into thinking that I needed all this extra space for work. I think it's just like, once again, I saw all the other creators in my space. I saw all the other photographers on the internet doing it, and I felt like I needed to be one of those people as well. When in reality, all it takes is a mental shift of you saying, hey, at 6 o'clock today, I'm done working and I'm gonna go do something with my life. And then when I come home, I'm coming home to my home, not my office. It's really not that difficult. So I don't really know about that one either. That's not really a concrete point. It might just be something that affects me, but it is something interesting. You know, your mindset can play such a big part in how you perceive things. So for me, I spent so much time convincing myself I needed a more dedicated office space. And then all it took was me shifting my mindset to no, you don't, to not need one. So I don't know what's up with that. That's pretty much everything I want to talk about today. That's the new setup. Obviously, you're going to see more of the apartment and more of how I'm living as these videos continue to come out and I continue to build out this workflow and everything. But I'm really enjoying it so far and I'm excited to share more of this process, more of these learning experiences with y'all and just bring you along for this new phase of the journey. So if you have any experience with any of this stuff, feel free to let me know in the comments. Definitely love to hear y'all's thoughts. Thank you so much for watching today. Do me a solid, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you're not yet. See y'all next time. Thank you.